Hi guys, we're back at Smash Fishing. We got a blowy old day and the tide's just low enough that I can get to a few lobster holes. So I'm gonna head down the beach in a minute. I'm just walking through a forest, so it's a bit sheltered. I'm not sure how much footage I'm gonna get today because it is blowing an absolute hoolie, but it's lovely around here in this little bit. Just enjoying it while it lasts. I'm definitely gonna be having this over my face today. We got 4-7 westerlies and I'm on the west coast, so stay tuned. It's Smash Fishing, woo! The size of that fungus, it's massive. Can't help it, start looking for things. Because we've had really big tides and really strong winds, I'm hoping all the clams and stuff have been churned up, because usually after a big storm in the past, we've had a lot of clams just out of this little corner. So I'm hoping those big juicy ones are the ones that are washed up. We've been walking for a while now. Gonna get there soon, baby. Hell yeah. Our first Venus of the day. It's gonna be a struggle to film today. It's absolutely blowing a gale, but that's an absolute beast. I've only been here a couple of minutes. That's what we want to see. I'm completely top behind the camera at the moment, so I'm going to get the best footage I can today, but that's a beautiful sized Venus clam, that. Absolute beautiful size. This is exactly what I was talking about. Check these puppies out. Really nice big clams, and they're all just washed up in the gullies. I can't film over there. That wind's so strong, my eyes have been streaming from that wind. And I'm finding a few. I found a little spot next to some rocks and that's got a few in, so I'm gonna have a good search around here and hopefully we can find a feed of them. I found a cockle as well, but I let that go. It's not worth it. I want one of these big boys. Can't even get my words out, baby. Let's get them. Yeah, boy. Look at that lovely big white one there. Sorry about the wind noise, guys. I'm trying to block it the best I can. I'm finding all sorts today. She's a beauty. Actually finding quite a lot more than I expected today. I put the camera on the chest mount so I can try and block it the best way. Awesome, we're on a good start. It's quite a cool looking clam. It's a bit more circular, that one. Getting out to the further parts now because the wind, the tide's gone right out. Oh, beautiful, look, there's another one. What happens is because we've had huge tides and big winds, all of this ground has been turned, so some of them would bury themselves back under, some of them would be stuck on the surface. So all I'm doing is just going around, pulling up the bits of shell that I see, and some of them are actually clams, baby. Size of this puppy. Oh yeah, that's what you call a big clam. That's a beauty right there. See, that's three of those we got now. Got another whopper. See, that's four of these giant ones I got now. Hell yeah, finding some beauties. There's quite a few cockles around, which is quite surprising. Don't usually see them on this beach. But no, it's nice to see so many. We've almost got enough for our cook now. I don't want to take everything I can. I just want enough for a feed. Check that out. I've got one Venus there and another chunky one. Calling these clams chunky monkeys. These are the best eating clams I've ever had. And I'm finding loads today just sitting there. Bonus. This is called a cockle. That's a really big one, that. A lot bigger than the rest that I found. And that there is the legal size. I put a hole in so I could just put them in. Makes it easier. But that's a nice big cockle, so we'll have that to the clam cook. I'm hitting the mother load at the moment. Find some real big, nice Venus clams. I'm just walking along the edge of the rocks here. And I've never found clams here before, but I'm finding them today. Is that one? That looks like one. There we go, that's another clam there. Really pretty colours on that one. I think that one's a bit small compared to the rest, so I'm gonna leave that one. But keep that big one there. Some really juicy clams. Can't believe how much is actually here. Look how pretty that one is. It's got like dark stripes with pink in it. It's amazing, the colours. I've got a nice old bag of clams now. So I think what I'm gonna do is give it another 10 minutes and then I'm gonna pop over and try and see if we can get to the lobster hole. Can only access this hole on a very low tide, so hopefully today's the day. Oops, shell. Nice scene over here. That looks good. Come on. Beauty. That's another cracking size one. Finding a good amount of different sorts of clams here. All I'm doing is literally just walking along the grooves, because that's where they're all going to be washed up. Little baby one. And I'm finding tons today. These big storms have definitely worked in my favour. Look at that beast. There's absolutely loads of them. I apologise about the wind noise, guys. I'm getting excited. Oh, nothing in that one. Check this out, guys. Oh, yeah. That right there is a Mr. Scallop. And the legal size limit is 100 millimetres. And my measure there is 1.5. So that's easily a keeper scallop right there. What a beauty. I've never found scallops on this beach before. That's mental. We got scallop for tea tonight, baby. Good old storm. Oh. And a clam to bonus it off. I'm moving out a bit now because I'm seeing more and more scallop shells. So I'm hoping I'll find another one. This one was just sitting there with its mouth open and I seen something flap and I was like, no way. That was a beast. Another juicy one.
Hell yeah.
Got a nice size clam there as well. God, this is brilliant forage. I did not expect to get so much today, but you can see that is some good foraging right there. Giving up on my clam quest. I found quite a few now. I'm just going to pour them out and take out any little ones. Look at that for a forage in the storm. That's not a massive scallop, but as a keeper, I've got endless amounts of these clams. This has been insane. So what I'm going to do is keep all these monsters. Oh, this is going to be an epic cook. I may let that go yet, I'm not too sure. Keep all of those. I've got a nice hard shell clam. That's a proper hard shell clam. These are Venuses. There's a few different sorts of Venuses as well. Big cockle. I'm going to let that go now. I've been spoilt for choice today. The storms always bring up clams anywhere you are in the world. A big storm, especially today. It's a 4-7 gale. I'm still down here foraging, baby. I can't believe I found a scallop on this beach. I never find them. I always find the shells, so that shows that they're just further out than the tide. That's awesome. These ones are all a bit small. I don't really want to keep them. So I think I'm going to let all of these go and keep my clams. That is an awesome find. There you go, guys. I've come out in the tide a bit so the scallop can swim out. It's lovely to see them on this beach, so I'm not going to keep it. We've got our few little clams and I make my way to the lobster hole now. It might be a bit blowy, so I'll just film whatever I can. Just lifted my first rock and got a little abalone under it. It's not legal, guys. Move that rock. Got a baby squat lobster there. Really little diddy thing. Baby cushions. Ooh, feisty little brown crab. Little brown crab there. Feisty little one that. Plunk it out of the way. There we go. what I'm doing is just pulling up the big rocks, the ones I think no one's pulled up, and just working my way through the grounds. These are awesome lobster grounds as well. Anywhere in the kelp beds you can find lobsters. You can bet a big old conger comes in here at low tide. I am right at the bottom of the tide here, and I don't think there's anything else in here. There was a little like wall of sand there, and I thought a lobster might have held itself up. There was nothing. Gutted. If anyone can tell me the name of this, I'm gonna look it up when I'm home. A gentleman's been digging rockworm. Yeah, it's got eggs as well, eh? He's been digging rockworm and dug this up. I think it's some sort of shrimp or prawn. Nice to see though. Don't know if you can see it there. There's a couple of little brown crabs wedged up in the rocks. That's what happens in the storms. All the crabs and the lobsters, everything just tries to buckle down into the holes. You find them everywhere. Found a little shallow spot here. It's absolutely peeing down now, so I'm not going to give it too much longer. Found a little sheltered spot here, and look at that, big bag of clams. I haven't found any ormers yet. I've just been looking in the holes around the corner here and trying to find a lobster, but I'm not getting lucky with one of them today, so it's not too bad. The weather's absolutely blowing a gale now. It's starting to gust, so I think I'm going to get out of it. A good tip for this: if you come out in any sort of bad weather, stay away from the shore edge, unless you know the bay really well. Because sometimes you can get a surge and the wave will come up way further than what they normally do. So it's a good thing to keep an eye out for, especially for anyone that's just starting this out. Don't want no one getting hurt, or just go on a good day at the end of the day. Stay tuned. It's a big old hairy crab right there, living inside of a shell. Awesome little crabs, got little whiskers on their legs and the head. Awesome to see. First keeper ormer of the day. Crushed him a little bit there. Good job I didn't crush the little one. And this is welling. So that's our first keeper ormer. Just enough of the shell there. Look, it's welling as well. So good job I didn't crush anything else then. That was a heavy rock. I've got to get it back. Come on. Another baby ormer there. Got a snake lock anemone. Few different species of stuff here. Got the broadclaw porcelain crabs, squat lobsters. Awesome little creatures around here. Came back to the same spot to get a couple more of these really big clams. Then I'm gonna head home. The weather's getting a bit worse now. Finding absolutely, literally hundreds of these Venus clams. It's the big ones I'm after now though. I'm literally walking around, I could pick up 100 of these in 5 minutes. They are absolutely everywhere. One there. But I'm looking for those big juicy ones. Look at that. Size of that one. That's a different sort. We've got so many different sorts of clams in this one. I'm gonna, I'll look up the different species we got. Hence the reason I don't try and name them all, because there are so many different species of clams that we got here. But just looking at the shells, these are the Venus clams, and I've got a few in here that I'm not too sure about. There's another one there, I'm not really sure what that one is, but all of these sort of bivalve clams, or what you want to call them, they're in a group called bivalves, and they're all edible around here. None can hurt you unless you've got a sewage outlet or something. It's good to get this sort of stuff straight off a clean beach. I think I've got enough now, so I'm going to set them down, go through them again, just make sure I haven't got no really small ones. Then we're back home to cook, baby. This is the end result for our forage. Check those out. One ormer, and we got a few different species of clam here. Check these out. I'm not sure if these are quahog or some sort of hard shell or ridge clam. We've got these big old boys. These are the delicious ones. I'm not too sure what this one is, but these are all edible. I know for 100% that these are all edible. That's the reason I'm taking them off the beach. But if you look at the different species we've got here, we've got a massive variety. There's a little cockle there. I didn't even have that in the bag. Yeah, the variety of clams here, it's mental. I did have some more circular white ones, but they were a bit small, so I let those go. But look at that. That's clam heaven right there. Big old pile of clams here. I'm home now. My dad's gonna come down and grab a handful of clams and the orma. I'm gonna cook the rest of them in the pot and have a good old feed. I can't eat all of this, so my dad will certainly help me. Back in the kitchen now, guys. Got my ingredients and the wok. And all I'm doing is putting a little bit of oil in there. Gonna wait for that to heat up. Then I'm gonna add my bacon. Well, my butter first, my bacon. My dad's just been round to pick up some clams. He's telling me to crush the garlic. So I'm gonna take his advice and use crushed garlic and use a little bit less of it. Had a little moan. So happy days, we're gonna try it that way with a bit of ginger, black pepper, salt, and then a good old dose of clams. So what I'm gonna do is add my butter, good old bit of butter. Gonna get that in there as well. Beautiful, good old wooden spatula. So I'll let the butter melt down now, get it nice and hot, and we'll start adding the ingredients. Everything's getting nice and hot now, so what I'm gonna do is add my bacon and my garlic. I'm using half the garlic I made. I'm gonna let all of that simmer through with a good old bit of ginger, black pepper, and a good old dose of salt. I'm gonna let all of that work together, getting all the flavors going. As I said in previous videos, I'm no chef, guys, but I'll give it a good go. Everything is smelling absolutely amazing. So what I'm gonna do now, so I've got all my clams here. You see some of them are slightly open. Get closed well. So I'm gonna get all my lovely clams straight in there. Beautiful. And what I'm gonna do is add a little bit of water for steam. And then add a plate on top. All I'm doing now is just going to steam this through until all of the clams are open. Then I'm going to give it an extra couple of minutes. Look at that. See it moving about. And these won't take long to open whatsoever. And when we're done, we're eating, baby. This is smelling absolutely awesome. Bad smell-o-vision now. As you can see, all the clams are open now. So I'm just gonna give them one extra minute just to be sure. Make sure any impurities are all cooked through. And then we're eating good. That is what you call a clam feast. I could not wait for this. I did have a look at the different clam species, and there is so many. I'm not gonna try and say every single name. I know these sort of stuff are bivalves, and
These are called Atlantic something, I'm pretty sure of, because they're circular, but there's a few different species of these as well. So, but the thing is, they are all edible, so we're safe. This smells absolutely amazing. So I'm gonna try one of these clams. Little bit of grit in those ones. I only had one of them. Now I'm gonna try my favorite, the big juicy ones. Yum. Oh, that's hot. Those right there remind me a lot of mussels. And they got a very thick shell to them as well. But you get such a big chunk of meat. It was well worth going out in the storm today just to get this. Whoa, that's hot. Get that bit of bivalve meat there. That's the good thing about storms. There's places where there's clams, the sand gets turned over, where usually you'll only find sort of three or four of these. On a storm, you'll find a plateful. My dad's got a good feed out of this as well. That smoky bacon definitely gives it that kick. These ones have no grit in whatsoever. Where is it? That one there was the grittiest clam so far. I'm gonna give one of the red Venuses a go. And as you can see, there's all different sorts of bivalves like this, where you've got these ones. There's some called banded ones, I think. There's so many different sorts. This one's a different sort as well. Hence the reason why I just don't even try to know every single name of these. Otherwise, I'm gonna get mixed up. So I either call them a hard shell clam. These ones are very similar. And that will do. But these are to die for. These big ones. Get some out of sauce. I feel like I'm dining in a restaurant right now. Oh, look, that's biggest clam of the day, that. Wherever he's gone. Right there. Ooh, hot. I've never tried one of these before. I've always found the shells, but I've never tried it. Ugh. Nah, not eating that one. That's got a big chunk of something in it. Those ones ain't too great. Maybe they need to be purged by any sort of bivalve or cockle or anything. Is always best if you leave them in water, even with an aerator, overnight or 24 hours, and it will expel all the sand. But I make videos, so I like to get it done quick, but I still enjoy it all the same. Absolutely delicious. Oh, this is one that I've never tried before either. And as you can see, it's got an appendage. Bit like a whelk, this thing. Bit rubbery, those ones. Where is it? I've never tried one of them before. It's a bit rubbery. I'm not too keen on that. But these ones here, oh, these are the next level when it comes to clams. I could eat these like mussels all day long. No more. Well, that's the end of it, guys. I've eaten all of my bivalve, and that one's full of grit. Yeah, those pale ones are full of grit. I've finished all my decent clams now. I'm a bit gutted. Oh, there's one. Bonus. If you like my channel, like and subscribe. There's going to be plenty more to come. Bit of a chew on that one. If anything, cook them a little bit less. But there's going to be plenty more to come, guys. I was very lucky to get out with this storm. I'm not sure how the video's gone yet. I'm hoping the wind noise isn't too bad. But very lucky to get this much clams and to feed my dad as well. So it's always a good day. So stay tuned. If you like my channel, like and subscribe. It's Smash Fishing. Woo!